Good morning, students. Today's topic is terms of credit of chapter number 3, money and credit. We have seen in the last class how banks work in between the lenders and the borrowers. But on what basis a lender will give a loan to a borrower? If you are giving 1 lakh or 10 lakh rupees to somebody, will you give the loan just like that? Or will you take any kind of guarantee that the borrower will repay to the lender? So that is what you call it as collateral. Collateral acts as a security. It is a security which the lender demands. Like if I am giving a loan of 10 lakh rupees to somebody, I will take a security against this loan. Security can be anything of the borrower. A borrower may keep a land as a security, building as a security, any vehicle as a security, any livestock as a security, any deposit with the banks. Like in the bank, if he has a deposit, then one can take a loan from that bank also, because bank will see that how much deposits you have in the bank. So that can also act as a collateral. And collateral is very, very important, because without collateral, nobody will give you a loan if it is a high amount especially. Now, why is it taken? What is the, why we are calling it as a security, or why is this collateral taken by a lender? Why a lender demands this collateral from a borrower? If the borrower fails to repay, suppose the one who has taken the loan, he fails to repay it, he is not able to pay it back, then the one who has given the loan, that is the lender, he has the right to sell the asset or collateral to obtain the payment. Like I was giving you example, like if I have given a loan to somebody 10 lakh rupees and that person has kept some land with me as a collateral. If that person is not able to repay me the loan, then I have a right to sell that land and make the money, whatever I have given. That is what is called as collateral. Properties such as, now they are further giving examples, properties such as land titles, that is the land in your name, deposits with the banks, livestock. These are some of the examples of the collateral. And we have further one very good example of a person who has taken a loan to buy a house, housing loan. Many times you might have seen many of the people take loan for different purposes, and mainly people take loan for buying a house. So let's see what Megha has done. Megha has taken a loan of rupees 5 lakh from the bank to purchase a house. Now she has taken a loan of rupees 5 lakh to purchase a house. Annual interest rate, that is per year, the interest rate is 12%. And the loan has to be repaid in 10 years. That is, every month she has to pay some amount of money. So, for 10 years she can pay that and repay the loan. And this is your monthly installment. That's what I said. Every month she has to pay some money along with the interest. Megha had to, now what all the bank will ask Megha? Bank will not give loan just like that. Just by taking your name, it will not give loan. Bank will require certain documents from Megha, the one who is taking the loan. What all bank has asked? Documents showing her employment records, that is where she is working, how much salary she is earning. These all documents are taken by the bank. Then only bank will give the loan. And after she gives all these, bank will verify bank will go to that particular institution or office where you are working. It will first confirm, take the details whether you are working there or not, for how many years you have been working in that organization, what is your salary, all these details it will take from your organization, from wherever you are working, and then only bank will give you the loan. Now it's only up to the loan which bank is giving, but what else do you think? Now what is the collateral here? Bank has just now checked your details of working, how much you are earning monthly, but bank needs certain collateral. Even if you are earning just like that, bank will not give you loan. So the bank, what bank has done, the bank has retained as collateral the papers of the new house. So the new house which Megha has bought, she has taken loan for that house. So the papers of that house will be with the bank now. It will not be, will be with the Megha. The new house papers, the papers on her name only. It is on the name of Megha only. But those papers will be kept by the bank. Once Megha repays the loan, after that is 10 years, after the 10 years, bank will give the papers to Megha. So that new house which we are talking about of Megha, that is acting as a collateral here. So now the which will be returned, so the house papers will be returned to Megha only when she repays the entire loan with the interest to the bank. So here, what is the collateral? Collateral is Megha's new house papers which the bank has kept with it. That's now you can fill this table which is shown over here after this example which I have done. You can fill it quickly. I know now all of you will be able to do this. For example, what is the loan amount, children, which Megha has taken? It is 5 lakh rupees. Duration of loan, for how many years? 10 years. What are the documents required? Papers of her service, wherever she is working, bank, what all, how much salary she is earning, that is the documents required. What is the interest rate bank is charging? 12% interest rate. What is the mode of repayment? It is monthly installment. How she is going to repay, that is the meaning. So monthly installment, every month she will pay some amount of money. What is the collateral in this case? Collateral is papers of her new house. Now, what all these which you have filled just now in this table, what all these are called as? These all which you have filled in this table, these all are called as terms of credit. What are they called as? Terms of credit. Terms of credit means conditions of credit. Credit is given, loan is given on certain conditions. Those conditions are called as terms of credit. So what are the terms of credit in Megha's case? Interest rate, collateral, documentation required, mode of repayment, all together are called as terms of credit. The terms of, but these terms of credit vary substantially from one credit arrangement to the another. This type of terms of credit will vary. Like if a businessman is taking a loan for his business, his terms of credit will vary because his interest rate will vary, mode of repayment may vary. So these conditions or these terms will vary from the one credit to the another credit. What type of credit you are taking, for how many months or how many years you are taking credit. So all those terms will change, and it will also change from the mode of the from where you are taking the loan. If you are taking the loan from bank, the terms of credit will be different. If you are taking a loan from a money lender, definitely the, if you are taking loan from money lender, so from one money lender to another money lender also terms of credit will vary. One money lender may charge 12% interest rate, another money lender may charge 16% interest rate, another trader may charge 24% interest rate. So the terms of credit will vary on what basis you are taking loan, for what purpose you are taking loan, from whom you are taking loan. it will vary from person to person also. So that is your terms of credit. We come to the questions which are there here, children. From every part, below every part, there are questions. If they are one marker, you do in the book itself. If they are not one markers, please do them in your registers. Why do lenders ask for collateral while lending? Lenders means the one who is giving loan. Why they ask collateral for lending? They ask collateral for lending because in case if the borrower is not able to repay the loan, then the lender can sell that collateral and make money. Because here collateral is here collateral is acting as a security. That is the answer, children. Next, given that a large number of people in our country are poor, we know that in our country there is so much of poverty. Does it in any way affect their capacity to borrow? So they are asking, because there are so many poor people in our country, does it affect their capacity to borrow? So are these people, poor people, able to take the loan? Will it affect them? Is it affecting them? Yes, the answer is yes. How it is affecting them? Because the poor people do not have the collateral. If we talk, for example, I have to give you an example also. For example, when we talk about a landless farmer, now he wants a loan from a bank. Do you think he is able to take the loan from a bank? No. Why? Because he does not have the collateral. He does not have the documents. So without documents, without collateral, bank will not give them the loan. That is how in our country, because there are so many poor people, it will affect their capacity to borrow. That is the answer. I hope you have followed. Yes, because in our country, large number of people are poor. They do not have any collateral. They do not have any documentation. It affects their capacity to borrow money from the banks. That is the answer, children. Next, we have the fill in the blanks. This you can do it here itself. While taking a loan, you put yourselves in this place. If you are taking a loan, borrower look for easy terms of credit. You are a borrower. You are taking a loan. Yes, we see that the terms, the conditions are easy, not complicated. Suppose we have to fill so many documents, we will not take a loan then, definitely, because filling so many documents is not easy. So we see that the terms of credit are easy. We see that the easy payment, repayment methods are there. Interest rate is low. So we see for all these conditions also. This means dash interest rate. Definitely. If I am a borrower or you are taking a loan, I am also taking a loan, then we see for low interest rate. Then dash conditions for repayment. Easy conditions for repayment. The terms of credit should be easy, easy to understand, easy to file. Dash collateral and documentation required. What do you want? Many papers to be filled or less of the documents? Less collateral, especially the collateral should be less. What we are giving as a guarantee should be less, and also less documentation is required. So that's how we complete the questions for this part. And now we come to the next part, children. That's your variety of credit arrangements. Now you have, these all is now stories only, children. Now you have seen that how we can take a loan from a bank. But we have also seen that all poor people cannot take loan from the bank because they do not have the collateral. They do not have the documents. If you go to a village, you will see that most of the people don't take loan from the bank because bank requires so many documents to be filled. So people generally take loan from the money lenders, traders, those who are there very nearby in the villages. So this is a survey about a village. Two children called as Rohit and Ranjan, after reading this credit part, they have visited to a village where they have seen that there are variety of credit arrangements. That means people take loan from the different people, different types of arrangements are there, different types of terms of credit are there. So let's see what is done here. These two people, they decided to talk to some people in their village. So let's see what they have recorded. We head directly for the fields. These two children have went to the fields where most farmers and laborers would be working at this time of the day. The fields are planted with potato crops. We first meet Shyamal, a small farmer in Sonpur, a small irrigated village. So which village they visited, children? They visited a village called as Sonpur village, where most of the farmers, they grow potato. So they first went to a person called as Shyamal. So I'm reading the story of Shyamal. You just see this. What is, after doing all the three story only, we can compare, children. Shyamal tells us that every season he needs loans for cultivation on his 1.5 acres of land. So he has just, he is a small farmer, 1.5 acres of land, and he takes a loan. Till a few years back, he would borrow money from the village moneylender at an interest rate of 5% per month, that is 60% per year. For the last few years, Shyamal has been borrowing from an agricultural trader in the village at an interest rate of 3% per month. Earlier, Shyamal used to take a loan from moneylender and the interest rate was very high, 5% per year, so 60% per annum. Now he is taking loan from a trader, agricultural trader, and the interest rate is little low, that is 3% per month. At the beginning of the cropping season, trader supplies the farm inputs as a credit, which is to be repaid when the crops are ready for harvest. Most of the farmers' children, they take loan for, they get the loan for 4 to 5 months. Before the sowing season, they take the loan, and after harvesting, they have to repay the loan. So this trader, instead of giving money, he has given all the inputs like seeds, fertilizers, pesticides, all of them to the farmer, Shyamal. And Shyamal has to give the money after finally he harvests his crop. Besides the interest charge on the loan, trader also makes the farmers promise to sell the crop to him. Now, the farmer has to promise, because he has taken the all the inputs without giving any money from the farmer, from the trader, the farmer has to promise that he will sell his crop only to the trader. This way, the trader can ensure that the money is repaid promptly. So this way, now the trader has got his collateral. In what manner he got his collateral? An assurance that farmer will sell his crop only to this trader. Also, since the crop prices are low after the harvest, the trader is able to make a profit from buying the crop at a low price. So what the trader will do? Trader will buy the crop from the farmer at a low price and sell the crop at a high price. So whatever the balance is there, that will be the trader's profit. Also, since the crop prices are low after the harvest, the trader is able to make a profit from buying the crop at a low price from the farmer and then selling it later when the prices have risen. So that is how he will make the profit. So this is how, this is a one kind of a collateral, children, you have seen. This is one kind of a loan which you have seen. So loan is not in the method of money which the Shyamal has taken. Shyamal has taken the loan in form of the inputs, the raw materials which he has taken from the trader. And a promise that he will sell his crop to the trader only, that is his collateral. And the trader also is making money because he is buying at a low rate from the farmer and selling at a high price in the market. So this is one kind of a loan from the Shyamal. Let's go to the next story, children. Next story is Arun. We next meet Arun, who is supervising the work of one farm laborer. He is just supervising the farm, one of the farm laborer. Arun has 7 acres of land. So he has 7 acres of land. He is a bit rich farmer. He is one of the few persons in Sonpur to receive bank loan for cultivation. He he has taken a loan from the bank, rural bank. The interest rate on the loan is 8.5% per annum. That's it, very low. So Arun has taken loan from a bank and his interest rate is just 8.5% per annum in comparison to Shyamal, who has taken a loan for 60% per annum. You can see who will be better here after the year is over and can be repaid anytime in the next 3 years. Not only he doesn't have to repay within 5 months, he can pay in the next 3 years. Arun plans to repay the loan after harvest by selling a part of the crop. He then intends to store the rest of the potatoes in a cold storage and apply for a fresh loan from the bank against the cold storage receipt. So Arun will sell a part of the crop and then repay the loan to the bank slowly, monthly installment. Not only this, rest of the potatoes he has stored in cold storage, and banks give loan upon the cold storage also. Banks give loan upon the cold storage also, because if he is not able to repay the loan, bank will sell those potatoes and make the loan, make the money. So that is how the cold storage also acts as a collateral. The bank offers this facility to farmers who have taken crop loan from them. So that is how Arun has taken loan from the bank and he is able to get profit, because he is giving only a interest rate of 8.5% per annum only. So he has done his planning well. Now we have the next story of Rama. Rama, just a minute. Rama is working in a neighboring field. She works as an agricultural laborer. So that means Rama is an agricultural laborer. She is a landless laborer. There are several months in the year when Rama has no work. Rama doesn't have any work. So in many times she doesn't get any work and needs credit to meet the daily expenses. She wants money for what? She doesn't have any land. She wants money for her daily expenses for her house, because she doesn't find the work every day. Expenses on, for example, expenses on sudden illness, functions in the family, etc. Rama has to depend on her employer, a medium landowner in Sonpur, for credit. From whom she is taking a loan? From employer where she is working under that person. That from that person she takes a loan. And that person is a medium landowner in Sonpur for credit. The landowner charges an interest rate of 5% per month. So the landowner from whom she is taking a loan, charging 5% per month, is again 60% per annum. Rama repays the money by working for the landowner. How she is repaying the loan? She is working in his field. Most of the time, Rama has to take a fresh loan before the previous loan has been repaid. So before she repays the old loan, she is taking a new loan. So her loan is never ending. At present, she owes the landowner rupees 5,000. That means in total, she has now to repay the loan of rupees 5,000. Though the landowner doesn't treat her well, that landowner is not treating Rama well also. She continues to work for him. She has to work in his field, since she cannot get loan from him when in need. Because she can get the loan from him whenever she wants. She cannot get a loan from bank because she doesn't have collateral. She doesn't have document. She doesn't have anything with her to keep as a security. So she is dependent on this landowner. Even if he doesn't treat her well, she is taking loan from him and she has to work under him. Rama tells us that the only source of credit for the landless people in Sonpur are the landowner employees. So people like Rama, there are many people in India like Rama who are landless farmers, and they all are dependent upon these kind of landowners or money lenders because they cannot get a loan from the bank. And that is why they are remaining as poor also, because they are getting loan at a very, very high interest rate. And this kind of loan at a high interest rate, they are never able to repay. For generations onwards, they have to work under those landowners. That is the reason there is so much of poverty, and we are not able to remove this poverty from our country. That is the reason. So this is these are the three different types of credit arrangements which we have seen. There is a fourth kind of credit, children, that is a new kind of a credit which is called as the credit from the cooperatives or loans from cooperatives. What are cooperatives? First of all, cooperative, cooperating with each other. The term tells the meaning. Now, under a cooperative, suppose there are 1,000 farmers in a region. All these 1,000 farmers think of cooperating with each other. What will they do? These 1,000 farmers will pool up the money. That means they will save some money every month. That money is collected from each one of them. Suppose 100 rupees every person contributes. So after contribution of 100 rupees, so that becomes 1 lakh rupees. That 1 lakh rupees will be kept by the leader, whosoever is the leader of that cooperative society. There will be few collective leaders, not one, maybe 10 leaders are there. All of them, they will keep that money. That money, from that money, any farmer who is the member of this, out of these 1,000 people, whosoever is the member, if suppose I am the member in that 1,000 people, I want a loan of rupees 10,000 rupees. I can take a loan from that cooperative farmers society because I am the member, 10,000 rupees, and the loan is given to me at a very, very low interest rate since I am the member. In the same way, you are also a member, you can also get a loan. Suppose you want a loan of 10,000 rupees, you will get the loan at a very low interest rate. That is how there are so many cooperative societies in our country which have been formed. These have been formed for the, what is the aim or objective of cooperatives? Aim or objective of cooperatives is welfare of the people. They don't work for the high amount of interest rate or profit. Cooperatives' aim is welfare of the people. There are many voluntary cooperatives. Even if like you people, like I'll tell you, like you are in class 10, you want to make your own cooperative society. So class 10 cooperative society of Gregorius School. Now what purpose? You want to help the poor children. So you will form a cooperative society. You will pool up your money. For example, instead of money, you can save your pencils, your books, which you are not using, all your stationery. And this stationery, you can give it to the poor children. What is it has become? It has become a cooperative society. So if the keep on members can be increased, few more children, now the whole school joins, 1,000, 2,000 children join together. That has become a cooperative society. In the same way, there are many people in India who want to work for the welfare of the society. They can form this kind of cooperative society and they sell all these inputs which are specially required by the farmers, etc. at a very low prices. For example, we have cooperative society for farmers who sell all the inputs like seeds, fertilizers, all these at low prices to the farmers. So let's just complete this part. Besides banks, the other major source of cheap credit in rural areas are the cooperative societies. Members of a cooperative pool their resources for cooperation in certain areas. There are several types of cooperatives possible, such as farmers cooperatives, weavers cooperatives are also there, industrial workers cooperatives are there, who gives loans at a very low interest rate. Krishak cooperative functions in a village not very far away from Sonpur. It has 2,300 farmers as members. It accepts deposits from its members with these deposits as collateral. Like 1 lakh rupees, if they collect from these members, that 1 lakh rupees, it is acting as a collateral. They can give this 1 lakh rupees to the bank as a collateral. And instead of these 1 lakh rupees, they can get more amount, say 2 lakh rupees also they can get as a loan, because 1 lakh rupees is acting as a collateral. And the cooperative, after taking the loan, and they give the loan to these farmers at a very low interest rate. Once these loans are repaid, another round of lending can take place. Once the members have taken the loan, when they repay the loan with interest rate, the bank will be repaid, and the bank, from the bank they can get a fresh loan. Krishak cooperative provides loans for the purchase of agricultural implements. So for all, what all purpose this society is giving the loans? For buying the raw materials, implements, like any kind of a machine, loans for cultivation, agricultural trade, fishery loans, for buying the net, etc., loans for construction of houses for the poor, variety of other expenses. So that is how a cooperative society works in a village. So it can be any cooperative society, not only in a village, even in a urban region also a cooperative society can be formed. Children, go through these all stories, and in the next class we will discuss these questions after, and you try to answer these questions, and then we will discuss, you can check your answers also, children. That's all, children, for today. After discussing the questions, we'll go to the next part, formal sector credit in India. I hope you have followed whatever we have done, children, today. That's all, children. Have a good day.